Well, hi everybody, and welcome to video number 3 in our Moodle Gradebook series. In our last episode, we looked at the category and items view, and we had a full gradebook to play with. In this episode, we're looking at an empty class, and we're going to create categories and grade items. So to begin, let's go to the gradebook. Let's move to the left-hand column, and either go to Course Menu and Gradebook, or the Gradebook tab at the top. Okay, what we see here is basically empty when compared to our last example. Let's go to the tabs at the top, or in the upper left-hand corner, the drop-down, and choose our categories and items. Here we are. And what you have here is a default category. You see, when you create anything in your course that is gradable, it automatically gets added to the gradebook, and by default there is one category, just like this one, with a course title. That's where all the information will go unless you make some changes. I'm finding an increasing number of professors prefer to create their categories first and then populate each category with specific assignments. Okay, to make a new grade category, let's come to the bottom of the page and click that button called Add a Category. This takes you to the new category view where you can set the details. You should put in a descriptive name. Let's use quiz, for example. And if you've decided that it has a particular value, for example, 25% of the grade, it's a good practice to add it to the description, although it has no impact on the calculations, it just helps make it clear. Now this next section, labeled grade item, is a misnomer. Please don't change any of the settings under this screen. This section refers to your category total settings, and you shouldn't change it. What you should do is come down just a little farther and make sure you click Save Changes at the bottom. Okay, now let's talk about creating grade items. Turns out this is a bigger deal than it's supposed to be, because a grade item can be created in two different ways. One method is to create the entry directly in the gradebook, the other created on our front page in our topics section with editing turned on, and use the create assignments. Any entries you create may be moved within the gradebook after you enter them, but anything you create here in the gradebook will not sort alphabetically, will not appear in the assignment block on the front page. You must grade them in the gradebook. You can't use quick grades. To show you what I mean, let's select Add a Grade Item, and let's create quiz number 1 worth 100 points. Now select the grade type you'd like. Your options are to choose value if you want a numerical score, or scale if this is a credit, no credit assignment. If I want the assignment to be credit, no credit, I then select scale from the grade drop-down type, and then credit, no credit from the scale drop-down. For reasons I can't even begin to explain, they're worth 2 points by default, and we can't change it. We are, however, working on that. If you want the assignment to be for a numerical value, I select value from the grade drop-down, and then enter the appropriate number into maximum grade. You can change the minimum, although realistically, the minimum should be 0. Further down the screen, you'll see that you can hide this item by checking that box. If the box is checked, it means students can't see their score for this grade item. And do make sure to save changes at the bottom. That's method number 1. Now let's go back to our main page of our course. Okay, we're going to come to the upper right-hand corner. We're going to turn our editing on. We're going to come down the right column and choose Blocks. And from blocks, we're going to choose activities. That'll appear right on top of the blocks choice. Let's use our arrows and move it to the left-hand column. It gets so crowded over there on the right. And notice we only see forums in the activities column. There is no mention of quiz number 1. Let's come over to topic number 1, topic outline 1, and add an activity. Using our drop-down arrow, we'll add an offline activity. We're going to call this Quiz 2. We're going to put some descriptive copy here. I'm going to copy and paste. It's a very useful feature. Here's where we set our grade. Now here in the drop-down, we can go from 1 to 250 points, credit, no credit, or satisfactory, and even a no grade value. I'm going to choose 100 points. We have the ability to set deadlines. I'm going to disable both of those, and there are a number of other choices you can make. We'll go into further detail, as I said, in other videos. What we do want to do now is come down to the bottom, grade category, use the drop-down, and we have created a quiz category. Let's put it in quiz. Save and return. And when we come to the front page, we're going to see that in the activities blocks, we have assignments. Let's select assignments. There's topic one, the name of the activity, all this information. You can actually go to quiz number two, and here's where that descriptive information is so important to you and to your students. Let's come to the upper right-hand corner. You can make an update to this assignment. Or notice it says no attempts have been made. Let's give it a click. Make sure your editing was turned on and quick grading in the lower right hand corner is checked. Save the preferences and you should be able to see your students and, in this case, grades of from 1 to 100 points. Seems our first person got a 99, so in my comments section I'm going to enter well done. It was a hard test. Let's go back to our front page, and let's go back to our gradebook, and let's go back to categories and items. So here we have it. The beige area represents your basic course default. The blue area is your categories, and the items in white are the activities for each category. We're going to get into greater detail in our next video. If you get into trouble before then, give us a call here at 3633 or stop by Library 315 because we are here to help.